the first place that piece that we played is the Bach HUG major. It was originally conceived for a pipe organ, such as the one you see over there. And I wish we had an opportunity tonight to hear that. But the sonority of the wind band really transcribes, or organizably transcribes well for wind band because of these old wind instruments. And the sonority is very, very similar. The next piece we're going to play is not the one listed in the program. We're going to change the order quite a bit. The next piece will be the Morsite Suite by Gustav Holst. This is a piece that Gustav Holst, one of the really great 20th century English composers, originally conceived for a British brass band. And that's a band without woodwinds. And he wrote this in the early 1930s. I can't remember exactly when Gustav Holst died, but it was shortly before his death he wrote this piece. The contest piece for the British Brass Band Festival seemed to be rewritten. And at that time, he did ask Dr. Dennis Graham to arrange it for what the British referred to as a military band. A military band in Great Britain is a band like our concert bands are here, with the full complement of woodwinds. And Dr. Wright did and didn't do this, but for some unknown reason, this piece was not published until 1983. It was basically an unknown work for wind band by one of the great band composers of history, Gustav Holst. It's in three movements, the scherzo, nocturne, and march. Morsite Suite by Gustav Holst.
Thank you. Thank you. featured soloist on this program. And 5 years later, here in Kentucky. And it brings back a lot of memories and trying to think of the sorts of things to say when I'm standing up here. I just want to say some of the things that are sometimes hard to say on a personal level. I'd like to thank Ralph Schweiger for taking me into his office a little more than 5 years ago and saying, "Have you ever considered a career in music? I think you'd be a darn good band director." I don't know if when he said that he thought he'd have to work with me in 5 years. Here I am. And I'd like to thank my family for support. We got my parents here, my grandmother. Just all those sorts of thank yous. I'd like to thank this band for making this first year of mine a whole lot of fun. And just thank you to everyone who's here. The next piece, the concert band, before I use my horn, is the prelude to Act One of La Traviata by Giuseppe Verdi. La Traviata is probably Verdi's most beloved tragedy, probably the most popular. It's a story of love, lost and found and lost again. And this is the tragic overture which sets up the stage for that story. It's prelude to La Traviata.
Thank you.
band alone is my performer for you this evening is Frank Erickson's Fantasy for Band. And a fantasy is much what you might think it would be. It's just kind of a conglomeration that wanders from here to there, really without much form, without much sense to it. Little tune here, little tune there, change of style, much as in a dream. And musically depicts a dream. And this is Frank Erickson's Fantasy for Band.
Thank you.
scene change down here, and just hopefully do it as quickly.
They have this great collection of panties called Feminine Style. All the styles you'd ever want. They're colorful, cute.
Thank you.
next piece of the program is the second piece that we're going to feature tonight that was originally conceived for a plate organ. And this is a concerto written by George Frederick Handel for plate organ and string orchestra. And Floyd Worley, who for many, many years was the chief arranger for the United States Air Force Band, who now resides in our own state of Michigan. But he was commissioned by the high school that one of our soloists tonight attended. And even though he wasn't involved in this premier performance, it was written for his high school band. we have two pieces left, and we're going to do the Spanish one first. Actually, I think this is a Mexican march, or at least it's used a lot in Latin America. And I was watching the PBS program Frontline a couple of weeks ago. It was called the Invasion of Panama a year later. Blessing of the anniversaries of St. Mary's Cathedral Church. Really appreciate that. Next week, both concert band and symphony band will travel to St. Louis, Missouri, to take part in the National Adjudicator's Invitation for Concert Band Festivals. Concert band will participate in the regional festival, and the symphony band will lead in the Grand National Festival. The symphony band met for the regional festival 2 years ago, and they earned a superior rating, which translates as a first division rating here at the commission, along with a first place trophy in the division. And because of that, they are eligible to take part in the Grand National in Indiana. The bands that will be there that will be competing with will be bands that have earned the highest rating at a regional festival in the last 2 years. We're really looking forward to it, and we appreciate, again, all the help that you have given us, and the community has given us, and the schools have given us. Students have really risen to the challenge in the last two months. It's been a tremendous role for us. They're forward to St. Louis, and I think they've learned a lot along the way.
Thank you. Mm-hmm.